Now we are going to discuss the topic fertilization. So fertilization is something that we know what that is, the fusion of gametes. So the fusion of gametes is called as fertilization. Here it is a vital event of sexual reproduction. So the most important event of sexual reproduction is this fusion of gametes, that is called as fertilization or syngamy. So these are frequently used, that is they are interchangeably used, the terms fertilization and syngamy. That is the fusion of gametes, when two gametes fuse together they form the diploid zygote. So here the where the two gametes will be haploid, where it forms a zygote which is diploid. So the vital event of sexual reproduction is the fusion of gametes, and the fusion of gametes is termed as syngamy or fertilization. So this syngamy then leads to the formation of diploid zygote. So here some examples, that is we may think that only the fertilization is the only process for an organism to reproduce. No, there are organisms which, or there are a single gamete in which fertilization occurs, sorry, does not occur but leads to the formation of new organisms. For example, rotifers, honeybees, some kinds of lizard, birds like turkey, in these organisms the female gametes alone without fertilization form the new organism. So they form new organisms without fertilization. So this process of formation of the offspring, we call it as parthenogenesis. So we call it as parthenogenesis. So the fertilization process may be external or internal. So if the fertilization, that is if the fusion of these gametes occurs outside the body, that is occurs in the external medium, then we tell them as external fertilization. Whereas if it occurs inside the body, we tell it as internal fertilization. So now, for example, for external is algae, bony fishes and some fishes, amphibians and frogs. So in this external fertilization, there is a medium, the maximum, the majority of the external fertilization using animals use water as their medium in order to enhance the chances of syngamy. So the fertilization, that is the fusion of the gametes, are chances has been enhanced when the medium is used as water. So here a large number of offsprings are produced when compared with internal fertilization. Large number of offsprings are produced in external fertilization, but the offsprings are vulnerable to predators. So they are vulnerable to predators. They are up to the reach of their adulthood, they has to be they have no security, or they have to be in fear on the effect they have towards by the predators. So the next is internal fertilization. So internal fertilization, for example, reptiles, plants, birds and mammals. For plants means gymnosperms, bryophytes and pteridophytes are the examples. So in which the fertilization or the syngamy occurs inside the body of the organism, so we call it as internal fertilization. Here the organisms which exhibit this internal fertilization, the male gametes will be motile, so that they have to reach the female gamete, that they have to reach the egg or ovum in order to produce the offspring, in order to undergo syngamy or fertilization. Here the number of sperms produced by the internal fertilization are large, so there is but there will be a significant reduction in the number of eggs produced. So there will be a significant reduction in the number of eggs. So if we take seed plants, if we take plants, this fertilization, so this fertilization in plants occurs in a different way. That is, here the male gametes which are non-motile in seed plants are carried to the male gamete by pollen tubes. We have studied, now the pollen grains are carried out to the ovary, that is to the egg, the ovule, by the pollen tubes in seed plants.